What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Markets right now, it's not really doing so hot, okay? Markets are crashing pretty hard, especially with the S&P 500 today, starting the day pretty red, and then SPY went all the way up to like almost green. It went down, went back up again. There's a lot of enthusiasm, and then a massive plummet down to negative 1.2%. Recently, markets are just absolutely disgusting. It's really, really hard to play. Tech is even worse right now. I mean, tech was just hovering at a very low point throughout the day at roughly negative 1.5, negative 2%. And then it just dipped even harder to negative 2.67%. If you check out the daily charts, tech almost looks like it will be going down perhaps towards $300 for the triple Q. That's going to be a very dangerous territory. Now, obviously, though, there are a lot of catalysts going on. I will be talking about what my thoughts about are the market is. I feel like there's a lot of individuals, they're trying to do something to the market. It almost makes no sense because a bunch of companies are reporting really good earnings, a lot of growth. I mean, the economy's opening back up, but the shares are dropping really hard. Almost makes no sense here. The Dow actually did really well. I mean, of all the indexes, the Dow was the only one that was actually pretty heavy green, but now it drops so much, it's currently in the red. If you check out the daily charts, Dow has always done extremely well. And obviously, if the markets just simply don't do well, if treasury bond yields just simply keep going up, we could be seeing the Dow DIA dropping all the way down to this red line before going back up again. Now, we've seen a bunch of really crazy stuff lately, especially with Jerome Powell in the markets, and investors, they're not really so confident in the markets anymore. I mean, when you see the markets being this gross and it's really hard to play, a lot of people just simply don't really play the markets anymore. Now, this activity right here really does remind us of the activity back in 2020, September and also November. Around this area, the markets were simply not really moving that much. A lot of increases, a lot of selling. And same thing over here. There's a lot of selling, a lot of buying, and we could be seeing another wave down before going back up again, forming a W-shaped graph or a upside down Batman-shaped graph. Now, what's going on? Jerome Powell yesterday did some pretty cool stuff, which actually dragged the markets up. I mean, tech was actually super red. It became super green. Same thing with the S&P 500, and Dow rallied even more. What Jerome Powell said was he will be keeping interest rates at near 0% until 2024. It's going to be the next few years before anything will be changing up. And so far, it's looking pretty nice. It's essentially like a really, really big confirmation. Jerome Powell essentially said that he would not be increasing interest rates until 2023. It will be at near zero, which is 0 to 0.25%. And this essentially gives a lot of confirmation bias to all of the traders out there and also long-term investors. If you guys don't know, if you increase the rates, it's actually really bad because then when businesses try to borrow money to open up more businesses or first-time business owners trying to open up their first store, it's very difficult because when interest rates are high, people are kind of turned off from opening businesses. And because when you open a business, it needs a lot of debts because you got to borrow money from the bank. And when you have interest rates at an all-time high, it doesn't look good. So you want to keep the interest as low as possible. That way it could stimulate more economic growth. More people start opening up stores. Now there's an overheating in the market. You increase the interest rates so people stop opening up stores. People stop borrowing money, stop taking out mortgages, have a little cool off before lowering it back down again. So right now, tech is experiencing some really wild stuff. It's incredibly hard to play. Of all the guys out there playing options, seriously, I feel you. The markets are way too difficult to play right now. There's a lot of ups, there's a lot of downs. And by the way, Jerome Powell has also said that we're not really scared about the economic stuff. I feel like the forecast will be going pretty well and we should be seeing an increase in domestic growth. That's what Powell said. And Powell also said that he's not really worried about the increased treasury yields either. He feels like everything's okay. And honestly though, if you look at the fundamentals, if you look deep down, look around the world, are there any trade wars? Not really. Any global conflicts? Not really. If you look around, are the companies having good earnings? Absolutely yes. So obviously this massive plummet down in the stock market really doesn't make much sense. And right now, US 10-year treasury yield jumps to above 1.75%. This is honestly pretty scary. Essentially, a bunch of rich guys, hedge funds out there are taking a bunch of money and then putting it into treasury bonds. This is why the treasury bonds are going up. And this is why when the bonds go up, the stocks go down. And a lot of investors are a little bit worried about this, since when you see a bunch of individuals putting their money in bonds, it means they're kind of looking at a more bearish stock market. Bonds are way more stable, way cheaper. It's a phenomenal way to park your money when you have a lot of it And when you feel like the economic times are not going so well, bonds are where you want to keep their money. But right now, bonds, it kind of makes no sense. The economy is opening up. I get it. There is inflation. There is maybe some conflicts here and there. But overall, the markets are pretty decently healthy. I mean, markets are slowly opening up. People got their stimulus checks. $1,400 already hit 90 million people. I mean, it's looking good. Everyone's buying stocks and everything is looking pretty fantastic, but the share prices are dropping. Then again though, maybe the stock prices have went up way too high, because for example, Triple Q, it's already hitting way above the all-time high price before the pandemic. Now it's at a super high price. So I understand that tech is going down a little bit, but what I don't understand is the S&P 500 dropping so heavily, and obviously that even the Dow got affected. I feel like this really doesn't make that much sense. And even Cramer said the same thing. Cramer says that bond traders spiking these yields would not win their battle against the Feds. And we learned that the same thing with being bearish around March of 2020. Remember how so many people started buying more puts, more people started shorting the market, and then the Feds started coming out, they're stimulating the markets and the shares started going back up. Yeah, I mean, when Powell and also the Feds want to do something, you don't want to challenge them. These guys are the bosses. If you want to challenge them, you're out of your league. And a lot of bears learned their lesson the hard way by buying puts around March when there's a lot of stimulus stuff coming out for the markets. I mean, it's like unlimited QE, all that crazy stuff, lowering the interest rates to near zero. You don't want to bet against the Feds. And the Feds aren't really super happy that bond yields are going up this much, and also the markets are tanking this much. Even Cramer is thinking this is pretty absurd. A lot of companies reported good earnings, good forecasts. I mean, literally yesterday, Powell said that interest rates will be kept at near zero, and we should be seeing some good economic growth. Stores are reopening. You also have massive vaccine distribution. Even my university is like, we should be having in-class courses next semester. I feel like this almost makes no sense here. I mean, I understand tech being completely garbage, but what I don't understand is so many other companies are struggling. Now, if you look at this graph, you know, massive surge down, stabilization, another surge down, and volume recently has been picking up. Now, we should be seeing stock prices going back up again when the majority of traders and also hedge fund guys take the money off of bonds and put it back in the markets. That's when we should be seeing a massive surge in the stock. Now, obviously, S&P 500, it's hitting very close to 400. I said this before yesterday, if it hits very close to 400, we should be seeing a slight tick down before going back up again. S&P 500, it's going up faster than I like it. Same thing with the Dow, it's going up way too fast. I feel like tech is severely undervalued, and tech should be treated way better than this. I mean, people are treating tech like it's a piece of rotten apple, like a piece of garbage. It's really not. It's kind of like a diamond in the haystack, in my opinion. And before we wrap up the video, definitely check out Coinbase. Link in the description below. Click on it, make a Coinbase account, deposit the money, and give us $250 worth of Bitcoin. I mean, this is free money right here. And plus, crypto recently has been doing pretty phenomenal. Thanks for watching.